listening to Halloween Unleashed.
What did you do with Marnie?
She's on the cutting room floor.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Cutting Room Floor, official first episode of Season 2. We're going to kick off Season 2 with our first Mask Collector's Spotlight, joined by Mr. Paul Fitzgerald, all the way from Ireland. How you doing, Paul?
How's it going, man? Appreciate you letting me on the show. It's a privilege. Nothing but respect for what you do. I'm wishing you all the best for Season 2 as well, buddy.
Oh, I appreciate that greatly. Yeah, it's quite the honor to have you on the show, because as anyone, you know, who's in my group or any group that you're active in knows that you have one hell of a collection and you take even better photos. So I can't wait to show everyone who's watching. And if those who aren't watching who are listening, we can at least talk about your pieces and they can watch it later. But you've got a killer collection for sure.
I appreciate that, man. It means a lot. It's what we're all in the hobby for, to get what we like and enjoy it. If people can enjoy my pieces and photos, then I'm happy they can, you know.
And that's one thing I want to ask you. You know, what is Halloween like as a holiday in regards to, you know, in Ireland versus in America?
You scale it down about 100 by about 100, maybe. It's nothing over here compared to what it is over in the States, what it is with you guys, you know. Now, it is, like, we go trick-or-treating and stuff, but it doesn't have as much of a, how should I put it, a cultural impact as it does in the States, if you know what I mean. Hey, I still enjoy it. Still, I've got a three-year-old boy. I still went out trick-or-treating with him this year. Got sued and booted, as you do, so we make the best of it, but sometimes I wish I'd love to be over in the States during Halloween just to check it out, you know.
Do y'all call it the same thing we do? Do you also call it trick-or-treating or anything different?
Yeah, trick-or-treating, Halloween, Samhain from Halloween 2, you know, yourself, I think it has, it comes from Irish heritage, as far as I'm aware, Samhain. I always laugh when Loomis calls it Samhain in H2. It's funny, I went to an all-Irish speaking school, so it's like, ever since I was like that height, I knew, no, you're getting it wrong, Loomis, for God's sake, you know?
Well, we Americans aren't too bright, you know, we have to pronounce it the way it's spelled or we get confused.
That's cool.
So how did you get started in horror? I watched Halloween for the first time when I was 6 and I was hooked. You know, what was that first movie, that first haunted house, that thing that got you into it?
It was Halloween, 100%. It was Halloween. I was about 6 and I remember we have a channel here. It's called Bravo. We used to have a channel over here and I remember distinctly my dad leaving me stay up late and watch Halloween, and for some reason, even to this day, I remember the bush scene where he steps out of the bush. I can remember it like it was yesterday, sitting down, and my dad used to lie down on the couch, and I'd sit over his legs, you know what I mean? I remember being like that height, but it always was Halloween. I remember I lived across the road from a video store, and I just rent Halloween 2, and you couldn't get the movies everywhere. So over the years, I'd visit other counties or I'd be away on holidays and I'd always check the record shops to see if they had like any Halloween. And it could have been the case that I can't remember in what order, but I watched like after the original, I watched like 6 and then 4 and then 2, you know, because I was gradually finding them when I was really young. Halloween was the first, but obviously I grew an affection towards horror movies and stuff after seeing Halloween. But like, I love horror. I love the even the backstories of movies, how they got made, development of movies, so on. But Halloween is the pinnacle. Like, I think in terms of all my interests, like whether it be sport, whether it be video games, movies, Halloween has always been the pinnacle. Always.
Any other particular franchises that you're fond of?
I enjoy Nightmare on Elm Street, of course, Friday the 13th, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, big fan of Jeepers Creepers, Scream, even Hatchet I caught. I was late to the party with Hatchet, but I think I checked out the full franchise about a year ago, and even though it's not a masterpiece or anything of that means, I still enjoyed it for what it was, you know. But slasher is just the subgenre is my favorite, you know. 100% would be slashers. And Jaws, forgot to mention Jaws.
Oh yeah, Jaws is great. Just for a little backstory on you, how old are you? Got any kids? Married?
Yeah, I'm 32, man. I'm an old man, late starter. I'm married. I'm with my wife since we were 17. We've got a 3.5-year-old son. He's still a bit too young yet. I'm looking forward to introducing him into the Halloween. You know, hopefully some Christmas will come where we'll have to buy him a mask. Really, it'll be for me, like, you know what I mean? But hopefully that'll work out someday, you know. But yeah, I think I'm married just 14 years together. I'm married 8, I think, you know, so. I got I started collecting dudes, you know.
Well, until he gets his, he'll just have to enjoy daddy's mask.
Yeah, true, yeah.
Does he see any of your collection? Does he get freaked out by any of
it? He actually has one or two Myers masks thrown downstairs, but he never got freaked out. Like, he knows Loomis, he knows Myers, and even for Halloween, like, I put on my rehaul tots and we went out trick-or-treating. He just didn't even bat an eyelid. It's just, oh, there's daddy and another one of his masks, you know. So, you know, I made sure that scare factor wouldn't be there for him, you know.
Yeah. What was your first piece that you ever got, and when did you get it?
You know, my first piece, I remember years ago when I must have been about 10 or 11 years of age, and we made a 20-minute long fan film, Halloween, me and my buddies back home. And I remember for weeks we saved off all our pocket money, and it was a Don Post. Now, I'm not sure what year, but I remember it was 50 Irish pounds at the time. And we saved up all our pocket money to get this mask after, I think we saved for like a month, 2 months. You know, you got 2 or 3 quid a week. You put it into a jar towards a mask. Had a really bad camera. So one summer holiday from school, we went out and made this fan film. But I just threw the mask in a closet after, and it just literally disintegrated. It really sickens me, though. You know, I'd really love, if I knew now, I'd be like, I remember it was a Don Post, but like at the time, I didn't know what. I just seen a Michael Myers mask, and I was like, yeah, we need that, you know.
Just kicked yourself for you know, not taking better care of it.
Yeah, my first, like, real one was probably one of the usual suspects, was a Tots H2. Like, well, when me and my wife moved into our first apartment, I had I had a small collection. Like, I've always collected, you know. I have a model DeLorean, a model Batmobile. There would be other franchises I'd be interested in. But I had a Tots H2. Like, and this was the holy grail at the time, you know what I mean? I ordered it from some website online, and it was nobody could touch the Tots H2, you know what I mean? But before that, I didn't, like, at that time, I did not know anything about the independent mass scene, you know?
Hey, I heard you say something about a DeLorean. You like the Back to the Future franchise?
I went to my wedding in a DeLorean, man.
As a, as a real Irishman, what do you think of Michael J. Fox's accent in the third movie?
No comment. No comment.
Not good.
Hey, he tries his best, to be fair. He tries his best, you know. But pity about number three. I'm not the biggest fan of number three, you know. But yeah, I do love the franchise, you know.
So as far as, you know, collection, everyone knows your collection kind of fluctuates because you don't settle for subpar. You always get the best that you can get. So what are you working with now? What's the first piece you want to show the people?
Oh, I suppose, like, at this time, I'm happy. There was a stage there where I was, like, there's pieces here I'll never get rid of. But obviously, certain opportunities arise where you have to build. You know, you have something, but you know, if I sell this and maybe put so much towards, I can go up a level. But we'll start with Myers. Sorry. This is my first indie. Like, my H2SM. Like, I adore this mask. Like, I this is my first independent artist mask. It's actually Roland's number two copy. But I absolutely adore this. I don't think the H2SM gets the love it deserves, you know, even though it's, let's say, the past 12 months, it has started to, you see a lot of them around now, but this, I remember opening up this box, and that was, yeah, this is it, you know, my first, from an artist, after going back and forth, conversating with an artist, getting that vibe, this was special when I opened it up, really special. Like, there's non-Myers here I like, but in terms of Myers, I'll never part with this H2SM.
And for anyone who doesn't know, you're a big fan of Roland Kelly and Death Row Masks, and you know, yeah, and that's definitely a quality piece.
I appreciate that, man. Yeah, I do. I love the H2SM. Roland is a good buddy of mine. You know, he's always taking care of me. We'll go back into it. I've a good story about a mask I'm about to show you in a while, which is quite interesting. But I think Roland is starting to get the credit he deserves. You know, I rank him, like, you obviously, you got your JCs, but let's say right behind him, definitely Roland Kelly. Definitely.
Oh yeah, I would agree. He's top five hands down.
Yeah. Totally agree. Good guy too. Shout out to Rollins. Good friend of mine.
I know you and me are both on the list for the jerk when it comes out. Definitely, you know, patiently awaiting that, because I know he's gonna knock that out of the park.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the jerk. I really am. I'm looking forward to the jerk. I'm happy. I know Roland was buzzing when he got it, so I've a joke with Roland. Obviously, it's 2020, pal. It's the year of the jerk. Don't worry, you know. So, no, I am. I'm looking forward to them. They're going to be good piece, man. Good piece. He's just consistently improving, I think, you know.
And you actually had something to do with him getting aware of the jerk being for sale, didn't you?
Yeah, I spotted it for sale. It was funny. I spotted it for sale, and I actually am. I messaged him and I said, hey, buddy, I'm after seeing the jerk. And my good friend Paddy Byrne, just like, I'd say maybe a month beforehand, Paddy got a jerk. And I remember seeing it and I was like, that is me. And I spotted the jerk was on sale. And I was text rolling, jerk's on sale. I spotted, buddy, in like 15 minutes, he texted me and he was like, yeah, all sorted. I bought it. So I was like, do me one favor, Roland. Promise me spot number one. And there we are. I got spot number one. So it all worked out, you know.
What's your next amazing piece you want to show the people?
I think we'll go non-Myers. We'll go non-Myers. I like this. This is my Freddy Krueger, Nightmare on Elm Street Part 1. glove made by a gentleman called Brandon Chatel. Also made the stand. I think for anybody who likes the slasher genre and Nightmare, I think this is definitely, whether it be whoever the artist is, I think a Freddy glove is, it's really cool to have, really cool piece to have within the collection, and this is, I rate this highly in my collection. I was blown away when I opened this. You know, how it got past customs, I don't really know, but I ain't gonna complain, you know.
But no, nice. I definitely gotta have a Freddy glove. I love my Boiler Room creation from Razor Gloves. One of these days I'm gonna step up to a higher tier one, because you know that's like a base, you know, generic one, but you know, it's just fun to play with it.
Yeah, they're cool. I don't know much about them, like, to be honest. I don't know the differences between the gloves from part one to, I know part four, I think, is kind of a design on the glove. All of them could, I really don't know, but it was, you know, it was one of them kind of, I had nothing to buy at the time, so I was like, yeah, a Freddy glove interests me, and it was one of those kind of pieces that when I opened the box, I was a lot happier than I thought I would be. Not that I thought, oh, I'm going to open the box and, oh, this is okay, but I was like, this is actually really cool, you know? So, nice piece. I think every collector should have a Freddy glove. I'm looking at a Dark Rider. I'd like I think I might hit one of them up this year. If the time is right and I spot a nice one, I might get one. Might, but we'll see.
For right now, that's the only Freddy glove you have?
Yeah. My collection consists of like 99.9% Myers, and then you got a bit of the other guys floating about, you know.
Oh yeah, for sure. I'm trying to get my Myers stuff up this year. You know, I did a lot of Jason collecting last year, so I gotta give Mikey
the Myers
the love he needs.
I think I said that to you a couple of weeks ago. 2020 for the year of the Myers for you. You've good list coming though, man. Good shouts. I'm looking forward to seeing them.
Oh yeah, I got my Don in from Matt a couple of days ago, so that was a good way to start the year. I've got many House of Horror Pro things coming this year.
Nice. You've the UL81?
I'm on the list for one. I was on the list higher for the UL78, but I told Matt, you know, just go ahead, get the pair done. I can wait for them at the same time and I'll get them together in one package. So my 78, I think, is done. And, you know, of course, the 81, you know, that mask debuted and he got, you know, dozens of requests. So it's amazing. I can't get over how good it is just to, you know, just for a slight retool on the UL75, which is already great. But yeah, he's made them both amazing pieces. So I was a little lower on the list for that one because I dragged my ass getting to him about that one. But yeah, for sure. I think it's in a couple of weeks he'll be getting to mine, and then I'll have both of them.
Nice. And be nice to open up two masks as well. It's a good feeling opening up.
Oh, yeah. I've never had to do, I've never done two in one day. Today I got my stands in from B-Man Gym. So
nice score.
I got those, and my camera right now is actually sitting on top of a box of hockey mask blends, so I'm going to paint up. So that's going to be the project for the next couple of days.
Good stuff. Nice, man. Keeping busy. Nice scores, by the way.
I appreciate that, especially coming from you, and you got one of the best collections in the business.
Appreciate that, man.
What's the next piece you want to talk about?
Yeah, we'll finish off with this, my Oz part 6. Yeah, you can see it good there. My Oz part 6. Mask and stand. Another piece I like. Another kind of piece like the Nightmare Glove. I didn't have anything in mind, and it just, I'm a big fan of Friday part 6. Possibly my favorite. I know not everybody agrees with that, but I don't know. I just enjoy how much part 6 is self-aware, if you know what I mean.
Oh, I agree totally. It's my favorite one to watch, and it's my favorite mask to paint.
It's a mean mask. I do intend on getting more Jason masks when the time is right, but I thought this one was a nice start. And I don't think he does the stands anymore. I think I caught the stand and he was about like a week or two after my orders. I seen he put out an announcement to say that they're too time consuming, and so I was chuffed to get one, because just I think they add to the piece, you know, it's easy to display, you know, so, but yeah, nice piece. I will get more in the future though. Maybe give you a shout.
I don't know if I'm quite good enough to be in Paul's collection yet.
No. Your day will come, buddy, but don't say that. You do good work. Do good work. Keep it up. I've already discussed it with you, eh?
Yeah, you did. I just want to get a little bit better. You know, what's actually in this box, you know, is a part 6. I've done a couple of those. This will be my first part 8, so we'll see how that goes.
Nice. Send me on pics of that, man. I look forward to it. I like the part 8 too, mind you.
I see you got a Halloween poster on the wall behind you.
Yeah, I got that online. I got that and spot my jaws. Yeah, that's a print I got in England. I got away with putting them up. That's like my kind of area of the wall, so I wish it was everywhere. But I got away with putting them two up because they're nice prints, you know. But she understands.
Mine does to a degree. She allowed me to have a closet for my stuff.
Yeah, you'll get outside that closet, man, in time. You know, it took me long.
The pumpkin's just a prop for the show. It's got to go back up when I'm done.
It's nice. John McNeil pumpkin on my right. Oh,
yep.
Yeah, they're nice pieces.
I won that one in a raffle, actually. I have two from him. I have an H2, and I have I have that one. I'm looking to get more from him. I actually have a Staples pumpkin, like a foam pumpkin to try. I want to try to carve a part 6. Not to sell them or anything, just to see if it's something I can try my hand at, see how it goes.
Yeah. Well, best of luck with it, man. They're nice pieces, the pumpkins.
Oh, yeah. Anyone who hasn't gotten it, you should hit up John McNeil for some of his pumpkins. He should still probably have some from the Halloween season right now.
Yeah.
Discounted, I think.
100%. That's nice work. Reminds me, I got to pick up sooner or later. Is it?
Oh, pumpkin. Yeah. What's the next thing we're going to show the people?
Well, we'll go to one of your favorites, buddy. I know you've got one. There's one goes. The Chris Morgan Rain in Red. Now, this was, out of all the masks I've got, in terms of what I was expecting and when I opened a box, this blew my fucking mind. Excuse the language.
There's no language parameters on this show.
This is a fine piece, man. And you know yourself, you have one. Like, I adore taking photos of this. I adore doing edits on this. I think it's such an awesome mask, man. Chris was A1 to deal with. Gave me a time frame. Stuck to his guns, literally not a day out. And quick, efficient. It arrived in like 5 days. Chris was nice enough to even upgrade my shipping free of charge. But this is a nice piece, man. And before I started collecting, sorry, buddy, my phone rang. Sorry.
Oh, no, not a problem.
Before I started collecting in terms of the sequel masks, I wasn't really that keen on them. You know, maybe bar the Rob Zombies I like, but I always liked the 6. I always wanted to get the 6. And you had a bit of a battle going on with the Rain and Reds for a while, so you know how much you know how nice these masks are, you know, but No, I really do like the red. I think it's a really nice six, you know, and good value as well, to be fair.
Personally, it's my favorite one that Chris makes. And I know, you know, it's not like the ones he has that comes from the screen mold, you know.
Yeah.
It's got, you know, a CGP, you know, origin about it. And the one I have is the proto for the 2019, which is the style that you have. But I love it to death. It's my favorite, and it might be the favorite mask that I have in my collection at the time, because, you know, just look at that thing. For those watching, you know, the video version is just spectacular. And like you said, we did go back and forth on the photo contest. I'd like to think that I won, but I think the people would agree your photos are much better.
Hey, it was stiff competition, man. Stiff competition. I seen a couple of your photos, and I was like, you fucking asshole. Fuck's sake. but no, look, I agree with you. I actually do feel it is my favorite six as well. And as you said, I know there's and taking nothing away from any of the, how should you put it, the higher level sixes that Chris produces. I got a lot of love for the red. I don't know. I think the red is really nice.
What else we got?
Right, where are we going to go? I got, shout out my buddy, Sean Michael Cadlick. He's turned into a good friend of mine. Has an absolutely epic Brothers Return mask. Takes serious shots with his Brothers Return. I got this, he calls it H88, the wrap. I got it to kind of go with the usual, the TOTS H4, which in my view is TOTS' nicest mask in terms of like looking like a movie, looking like the movie mask. I think it's a nice piece, you know. I wouldn't be too keen personally on the H4 mask, but I said I'll give the TOTS a go. And it is for your money. If you're filling a gap and want a bit of a H4, like I got the wrap, and I just wanted, just thought the TOTS to complement this would be nice to have. But nice piece, particularly I enjoy the wrap as well. It's a nice little piece to have, I have to say.
Oh, I agree. I got my TOTS H4 for $25, which I couldn't pass up. You know, it looks just like the stunt mask. And I'll go ahead and give him a shout-out. Ryan Truhoff, I think I'm pronouncing his name right.
Yeah, all
right. He does an amazing rehaul on the TOTS H4, and he just does great paint work in general. So if you get one, I'd highly suggest you send it on over to him, because he'll knock it out of the park.
You know, man, I actually spotted his work and thought the same myself. I was like, damn, he does good work. He does nice work. So maybe something I'll look at in the future. But I totally agree with you. 100% I agree with you.
And that rap is very good, because if I'm correct, I don't think Sean makes those anymore.
No, I think he's a good friend of mine. I talk to him a lot. He's a talented guy, and I know he was. When he stopped making them, I was like, you should keep making them, man. They are cool, you know, but maybe someday he'll get back to them. But nice little piece, too.
In the meantime, people will just have to deal with mine. So that's all you got as far as H4 stuff?
Yeah, that's my, that is, bar my, oh yeah, I've got, bar my blood tears and H40, that's my sequel. I might work in it a bit, but we'll see what the future holds, buddy. I don't actually have a clear plan at the minute. I went hell for leather last year, and so I'm trying to slow down a small bit and get my bearings before I jump the gun and go to my next venture, let's say.
Oh yeah, you know, you've seen the list of masks I want to get, and you know, it definitely the total starts to add up, you know, after enough time, especially when you have a wife and a kid.
Yeah, but look, as I said, she supports it, so You know, and as I said to you, I was it keeps us young, man. You know, it keeps me young, keeps my mind entertained. I adore this hobby. Absolutely adore it ever since I came into it. And to say hi to he helped me along the way, a good friend of mine, Paddy Byrne, as well. How he's the reason why I dabbled into the hobby. Like, I was members of pages for years, and I didn't know a DIY from a JC piece. They all just looked amazing, and I remember I seen Paddy, and I reached out to him, and he gave me major help to get into the hobby. But I adore it. It's there to have fun with, you know, and be happy with. And look, we're all in the same game. We all just want to enjoy it. And you meet some good people, man. I've met some, yourself included. I've met some good people in the time I've collecting. I've been collecting, and I just hope it'll continue to last, you know, because I have a ball doing it.
I'd like to have Paddy on the show. He's got just an outstanding collection. He's incredible. Got to have 50 pieces.
Incredible, dude.
To be a two-part episode.
Jesus, you'd nearly fill a season, man. I think he's like 70-something altogether.
Probably more,
because, like, I talk to him on a regular basis. And you know, he's so much, man, that he mentions a mask he has. And I go, fuck, I forgot he even had that mask. You know what I mean? Because he has that many. But yeah, I'm always at him. I'd love to call to him and see the collection. But, you know, I'd say that thing could be locked up, the security. I'd say he's got guard dogs all around that house, man.
He's got Good a flaming go. Moat full go. Of fireproof alligators.
Yeah.
So what else we got to show the people? I know there's a couple coming up that I'm a big fan of.
Yeah, we've got... Where will we go? I'll do quickly run by my second H2SM, Blood Tears. Another beautiful mask. Again, going back into the reason why I love the H2SM, I got bloody two of them. You know, I just I just let Roland do his thing. I just wanted clean. I wanted the Blood Tears to be clean. And I said, just do your thing, buddy. You know, it actually came with another mask I'm about to show you. But that's my H2SM, my love for the H2SM anyway. And we'll go quickly. Another one of Roland's piece, my thoughts, 2018. He done, I think this was only his second one. Nice hair in it, man. The hair is nice and grungy. I enjoyed this.
I didn't
piece.
Know he did any of those.
Yeah. Sorry. I didn't think you, I thought you could see them. Yeah, he done like, I think only a handful, you know, but I got that. I have this a while now, but good work again from Roland. And we'll go, sorry dude, I'm sure you'll enjoy this one, the SS78, one of my recent additions. This is a serious piece, man. Like, in terms of when I stuff my masks a lot, and I've been taught by other people as well to the easiest way to explain it is I stuff it like it's a head in it, you know what I mean? But this, like, you just put this on the stand, the sculpt just does the work. It's a fantastic mask, man. It really, really is really nice. And again, Chris A1, I remember he even was early with it. He I put I, I I messaged him and I said, can I get on this? I said, there's no rush, Chris. Whenever you're ready, I know. Because he literally, Hunter, by the way, shout out to Hunter, and his SS is phenomenal, and his GKY for that matter, and his photos, takes really nice photos. But I messaged Chris and I said, look, there's no rush. Whenever you're ready. And he said, yeah, it'll be, probably be after Christmas. I'm really busy. About a month later, he just messaged me, which was like November. And he was like, I am good to go. I can knock out your SS-78 whenever you're ready. And I, at this point, at that time, I didn't give him any money or anything. So he wasn't within his right to push this mask up like 2 months sooner, you know what I mean? So it was a nice surprise. I think I got it after like a month and a half, but beautiful piece. Nice. The hair is nice and matty, and I love the cuts. I think it's just beautiful piece. Really is.
What do you think of the new GKY mold that he fixed the crown of the head?
It's fantastic. As well, I really, again, as I said, I already mentioned Hunter. I like his H2. I think when I first seen that, I was like, damn, that's nice. My personal favorite out of Chris is the SS, taking nothing away from his other work. Ghost deserves a shout out as well. Of course, you know, I know you're GKY. You're going to get a GKY? Yep,
I'm definitely getting me a GKY. I was going to do the SS-78 when he did that, but then when I saw the GKY, personally, I like the GKY more. That's just my opinion. Definitely going to get one, but either way, they're both fucking fantastic.
You're not going to go wrong with any of those masks, really. Again, it's the name of the game in the hobby. It's your personal preference when you think about it. But I agree. You're not going to go wrong. I look forward to seeing that piece when you get it. But yeah, I do. I think the SS was another. I remember I first seen Hunter's copy and I was like, damn, have to get that now for fuck's sake. But you know, it is what it is. You know, you see something new and you're like, oh, damn it. You know.
No, I think Hunter's the real competition as far as, you know, the photo edits of the mask he takes.
I have to say his photos are phenomenal. His SS, his copies, it's a damn nice copy too. And he has other pieces that I haven't mentioned. You know, he's a mean looking collection. You know, but I agree, he takes lovely photos as well. Lovely photos.
What else have we got to show the people?
Right, we'll go to my nightmare UL from Mr. Kelly. This is what I have coming up is possibly the highest end, but this will always be special to me. This has story behind it, man, that like I initially ordered a Castle 75K from Freddy Lopper and things didn't pan out with Freddy, so I had to cancel the order. Then I was kind of stuck and I got on to Roland and I think this was after lot of conversation. I think this was the first blank that he officially got off Nico's at NAG, as far as I'm aware. But that was some wait between Freddie and everything. So then I remember Roland sent me a picture of the cuts, the eye cuts, and I remember seeing the eye cuts and saying to myself, shit, this is going to be nice. You know, as soon as I seen the cuts, I said, he's going to kill it. And I remember he messaged me and he said, are you ready? I have it done. And he sent me pictures. And man, my mind was blown away when I seen the photos. So that was done. It actually, I got it done with my blood tears, and he sent them. What we didn't realize is they were coming on a container on a boat. So they took about 2.5 months from leaving him to get to me. But worth every second of the wait. And shout out to Roland as well. He messaged me nearly every day of that 2.5 months, man. He was ringing Canadian Postal Service, checking for updates. He found out, I have to say, like anybody else wouldn't have done it, but he was so cool about it. And he was as happy as me when they arrived. You know, we were, like, he texted me when it updated that it got to the country after like 2.5 months. I woke up to a message in the morning to Roland, and I was like, yeah, it arrived. But my mind was blown when I opened it. I adore this, man. I adore this mask. It's beautiful.
I think that mask and you showing it off is half the reason that Roland's so busy now, is you blew his popularity up. So I'm blaming you, you bastard, for this wait for the jerk.
Yeah, you said that. Hey, look, again, going back to Roland. Roland is so underrated, man. Like, he's just crazily underrated. You know, he does, but he's a good guy. But I do, I love the UL. I really, really adore that mask. That will go nowhere. I'm proud of that mask. Proud of it after the journey it took, and to come in one piece, you know, and to be as nice as it is. It's I'm damn chuffed to have it. I'll put it that way.
I'd like to get him on the show and talk to him, interview him, because he is, like you said, just a tremendous artist.
Adores the hobby too. Adores the hobby. You know, he's a good guy. He's a mean collection there as well. He's a bit afraid to show it at times, but well, he is a mean collection. I know that for sure.
What else you got in your collection to show off?
We're nearly there, Dylan. Yeah, we are. I didn't show it. I have. It's being posted on Friday. I regrettably sold my Scareware head skinner. I'm trying to focus a bit more on Myers. You know, an absolutely fantastic piece though. But that's going to a new good home, hopefully. But maybe someday I'll replace it with another TCM. I like Lawrence's Bad Man mask. That one really, really sticks out for me. Another mean collection, by the way, Lawrence. But I suppose last but not least, my newest baby.
This thing is just, oh my God, it's fucking beautiful.
The JC98 Proto. I don't know if you can see it. First gen special edition is 2017 personal copy. This thing is phenomenal, man. Like, I mean, you look at a JC in your hand and you're like, wow. Now, the only thing is, it is tiny. Like, I've got a seriously small head, Dylan, it doesn't even fit me, but in a way I'm pleased because it stopped me from touching it. I don't want to touch it, I just want to look at it. But
what size is it?
I don't even know, like, man, I go UL fits me. UL's about 23, I think. This is, I'd say 22. But it's just, like, as you can see, he's second to none, man. You know, and to be honest, it's a JC mask as a mask I never ever thought I'd have, but it's absolutely phenomenal. Such a beautiful beast. Yeah. You're waiting. You have three spots, don't you?
I've got five.
Five?
Yeah, I had three. No, I had two. I plan to get a Castle 75K and a 98 test mold. And then I was thinking, I'd like to have like a complete Kirk H1, H2 set all based on the same mass. So I'm going to go 98 Proto Trio. So I've got a set of two and then a set of three spots.
Yeah. Nice. I'd love to get a one plan I do have this year is getting a JC Castle. I'd love to get. Timing is right. I'd love a JC Castle, but to be fair, man, whatever mask you send to him, you're not going to go too far wrong. Like he really, really, really does some fine work, you know.
He's the GOAT.
Yeah, 100%. That proto back there, like, is just and actually, it's so nice that those photos I took the weekend, my wife actually suggested to me, take the proto, bring out the proto with us, because we were going away and we were visiting. I was like, yeah, good idea. I'm happy I did now, but phenomenal, buddy. Such an epic piece.
Yeah, and you take some very unique photos. Like, you know, Hunter was taking pictures by a lake full of ducks. You took yours out into outside to get, you know, a little air. We've been seeing people taking pictures in the snow. I'm liking the unique photos. You know, like Chris said before on another episode, you know, get your masks out of the house. Get them out of the bathroom. Get them out of, you know, that yellow light, you know. Get them outside.
I totally agree. I it's something I'm going to continue to do. I think it's hard to show a mask not in person, you know. I think they all look better in person, but I totally agree with you. I enjoyed Michael. I think put up nice photos. Hunter, of course, but I love seeing it. I love seeing, and I totally agree with what you said. With what Chris said, you need to just get them out, get a bit of air, get those. That's why we all do it, man. You know, we're all there. I appreciate seeing any piece as much as I appreciate looking at my own. You know, I think it's what we're all here to enjoy ourselves. So I'll myself will definitely be taking more photos, and I'm going to make sure I get these spots. If I'm going away for a night or something, I'll take one mask, you know.
It's just unfortunate, you know. I wish more people could have as positive as an outlook on the hobby as you do, and you know, you don't go around. If you see something you don't like, you just keep scrolling, you know. You don't stop and ruin somebody's day.
Yeah, look, man, people bitch. It's human nature, you know. I've bitched about people before. You've bitched about people before. Everybody's done it. You know, but I think there's more important things in life than latex masks. You know what I mean? Obviously, I this hobby is a part of my life now, you could say, and all of ours for that matter. But I do it for the sole reason that it's we're here to enjoy ourselves. We're here to help each other out. Pat each other on the back when they get new pieces, and give each other a thumbs up when we post pictures of pieces, and try and get it, have each other's backs at the same time, you know. But that's why I'm in it, man. You all should just enjoy yourselves, of course. And you're doing it as well with being on the Unleashed podcast and doing your own thing as well. You know, you're expanding, which is good. You know, I'd love to do it myself sometime. I was quite nervous recording this with you, but I've actually enjoyed it. You know, it's nice to sit down and speak for an hour about something you adore. Like, because I go to work on a day-to-day basis. You're not going to sit down in the canteen and somebody's going to be next to you having lunch working. I work in retail in a different department. I'm not going to look up at them and say, oh, here, do you want to see pictures of my SS78 I took last night? It's really nice. You know, so we enjoy this hobby in a confined space, if you know what I mean, man. We're on the phone or or taking photos, like it's good to speak to somebody, you know, and speak to somebody about how much we love.
Yeah, it's never been great, you know. I talk to you all the time. I've been talking to all the people I talk to on a daily basis, you know. From doing this show, I've actually gotten to talk to a lot of people, not only, you know, on the phone, but, you know, face-to-face. You know, so it's been awesome to genuinely talk to you as opposed to, you know, just typing to each other.
Goes both ways, man. Goes both ways. I have to say, I've really enjoyed it. It's nice. I've got to put them all back now, but other than that, you know... I've enjoyed it.
It's been a pleasure having you on the show, Paul, and I look forward to the next episode we do. I don't know who it's going to be, but until next time, for Paul Fitzgerald, I've been Dylan Cloud, and we'll leave it here on the cutting room floor.